hot wings in the morning. Grand Rapids rocks all day. 97.9 GRD rocks.
Sunny today, 48 the high. You were about to experience some sort of sports chaos.
Oh, yeah.
I mean,
yeah,
that
we've
in
got
a good
athletes
way.
In here, so it's going to go all crazy now.
It's an opening day double header benefit put together by BCF Financial Services. Kevin Feifeld, who was one of the first to spill coffee in our studio. Not the last.
That's true. No,
I
not
know
the
I've,
last.
I've got a couple stains from over there where I sat. Coffee, specifically.
Yeah.
I
want to
make sure we all know that's coffee.
Hello. There are some other mysteries in here.
Yeah, there's some real mysteries. Our good friend Ray Bentley is back. Hi, Ray.
What's going on, guys?
Hey, man.
And Dave Rozema is here, Tiger with the 1984 World Series team.
Good to see you. Thank you for having me.
And there are several stories that that Rosie told. I was just telling him off the air. Yeah. I go, your story about sneaking booze to the bullpen because you wanted a pregame for the concert afterwards.
You got to get tuned up for a concert. You know what I mean? So a couple beers in a bullpen on an 85-degree day. Perfect.
Perfect. Perfect. Ray, did you ever get drunk during a football game?
No. I did actually run out onto the field with a big dip in my lip one time
because
the guy who was supposed to be out there didn't go.
Yeah.
So I'm out. So I had to run out there. And, of course, the guy across from me was a former teammate.
Yeah.
And he saw my lip bulging.
Yeah.
And he got his hand under my face mask and face washed me.
Gross. Oh,
I puked all over that field. I got to tell you, it was brutal. I learned a valuable lesson.
Yeah. You barfed a lot on the
field. There's that. There's the squincher.
Yeah.
A lot of me is spread all over this country, boys.
Yeah. In more than one way, I opt out it.
We're not even talking about, like, hotels.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
that's a whole different about that. Thing. What was your, didn't you have a nom de plume, a fake name when you checked into the hotels?
No. I wanted to be Rosie because you never know who's going to show up.
it might be
you
good.
You remember those peak holes?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Next room.
Yeah. What was, because the city of Detroit and the whole state of Michigan in 84 for the Tigers. It was such a. I mean, I don't know that any sports championship has ever been that big as that year. And how old were you? Like 24, 25?
26.
So prime groupie situation.
Prime groupie 26, had that Dirk Diggler mustache.
Right.
A little longer hair, maybe parted in the middle. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Tan from Florida.
There's probably whole suburbs of Detroit with kids who look just like you.
Everyone in Wyandotte looks like Dave.
I hope they're doing well. No one's knocking the door yet. But, it was a magical season. Especially when you start off 35-5.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It felt like divine at that point. Like, they can't lose.
It was totally, you look at each other in the locker room going, well, I hope you don't screw this thing up.
Yeah.
Because people are going to remember, not 35-5, wow, they really screwed that up.
Right. You don't want to be the team that best start in Major League Baseball history. And then you don't want to be in the conversation of best team that never won.
That never won.
Right.
Oh, that conversation.
I'm
familiar with that one.
Speaking of that, Ray Bentley's here, former Buffalo Bill.
Yeah.
0-4 in the Super Bowl. Okay.
Yeah.
I see what you're saying. Yeah, you didn't want that, Dave. I can tell you from experience.
Yeah. It's a bad feeling, I'm sure.
Played up in Buffalo baseball at the Memorial
Pilots,
Stadium.
Triple A.
I think your picture was still up there, Memorial Stadium.
Yeah,
you and
in the post office right next door.
Ray, did you ever play baseball?
Yes, I did.
Were you good?
I was a phenom until the age 13.
Were you a catcher?
No, my brother was the catcher. I was the pitcher.
Okay,
I always tried to keep it that way.
Okay, that's
that
your preference.
So weird.
That did sound weird.
You called the wrong sign.
Yeah,
it was his fault.
You don't even want to know what I did.
When you weren't pitching, what were you doing?
Third base, corner, and it was
home
only because
hitter.
I didn't have quick enough reactions to knock the ball down, but generally it hit me.
You're big enough.
So I'd scoop it right up and throw it over to first. Bang bang! We got him every time.
Dave, did you play football?
Yes, I did.
What were you?
Quarterback.
I was going to say,
defensive end.
Really?
Oh, there's a combination.
Tall, boom. Well, you know what? Second-string quarterback.
Okay.
You had to be fast in, you know, high school.
Yeah.
So I was a little bit slow, but I had a good right arm.
When you played high school football, at least in the era where you played, because even when we were in high school, most people, it was still, okay, we're going to run the football almost every play.
90% of the time.
You would have been an option quarterback.
Yeah, I would have been option, plus a 10-yard pass. Boom! Whack! throw it so hard. Yeah. I'm a little bit nervous.
Yeah. Only had the fastball at that time.
No touch on that. Coach calls a screen, and your running back's like, oh, God, it's here so cold. My hands are going to fall off.
Yeah. Where's that rib protector?
Yep. Broke another hand.
Kind of serious, but, I mean, both of you guys had, obviously, professional careers. Dave Rozema with us with the Tigers in Major League Baseball, Ray with a variety of teams, most notably the Buffalo Bills, won a championship with the Michigan Panthers in the USFL. But you see kids now where they specialize, like seventh grade. All right, well, this kid's going to be good at baseball or whatever. I guess for each of you, like Dave, when did you specialize and become a baseball player?
Especially as a
pitcher.
Never.
Really?
I really think there's a problem in today's athletes. I mean, I played football. I played golf after I got kicked off the football team. I played basketball for 4 years, high school. I played baseball 4 years of high school. You know, there's different conditioning programs for every sport.
Right.
And so I think today they just specialize in one, and it doesn't give you the flexibility of the quickness in basketball is crazy. The brute strength of football is that. Baseball is more thinking and quick steps. I mean, it's pretty weird where I think more kids should do more athletics, and it trains different parts of your body and your brain.
Yeah, I agree. I think you need to compete regardless of what the endeavor is. Mm-hmm. And if kids spend 2 out of the 3 seasons of the year training, mm-hmm, and they're not competing, not only are they robbing themselves of that experience, but that's where you get, you know, you find out who you are. You get faced in those situations, mm-hmm, where you got to dig down and give it as whatever you got, and you don't get that anymore.
See, I find that to be absolutely true, because that's why I was in both marching band and choir.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
You got to spread yourself around.
Exactly. I wanted to make sure I was exercising all of my different muscle groups.
When you have absolutely no talent, you have to spread it out.
That's true.
And I both smoked pot and drank beer.
See? We did that in high school, too. A
couple of dual threats.
Is that the getting picked off the football team story?
You could have still played sports.
Oh, yeah. I had no idea. I was, you know, in my off season, I was training to watch TV and eat too much food.
Perfect.
I had it all year round.
But look at you now.
Exactly. Look at me now. Look. I told Nicole yesterday, I go, you know, to look like this, it's a lifestyle choice. It's not just something you do for a week or a month.
No. You have to commit.
It's a lifetime commitment.
This is how you live.
Yeah. Why did you get kicked off the football team?
Well, let me see.
Did you
football team? My brother was a good athlete. Tom, I was 10th grade. He was a senior. Played Creston. Creston was number 4 in the state. Central could have been an upset. 5 interceptions.
Okay.
Couple off the hands. 1 off the helmet. Punted. Blocked. They lose 18-17. Houseman Field. I go in the locker room to give him his coat, and they just start ripping me. And pretty soon a couple of F-bombs came out, mm-hmm, and my coach goes, you know what? Monday, I want to see you. JV coach goes, you know what? Don't think about coming up for football practice because you're off the team. I went, you know what? Get F-bombed.
Yeah.
I don't need to play football. I'll go play golf.
Right.
So the coach in the varsity team goes, kick me out of school for 3 days for saying the F-bomb to him. And then he said, never come up for football. So I said, you know what? I don't really care.
Right.
We'll join the golf team. Golf team, city champions.
There you go.
There you go.
I got my sweater.
You
with a
showed down.
So you got kicked off the football team when you were on JV, when you went into the varsity locker room?
Yeah.
Well, that's impressive.
That's bad timing.
I was a big guy.
Yeah, that's really good.
You know, I was a varsity football player. Baseball guy. They knew I was little Rose, but big Rose, 6'5".
Yeah.
Next quarterback in the line.
Karate kick anybody in
No,
there,
not
you?
In those days.
Right. Yeah, what is, I know that you're 0-1 in the major leagues in karate kicks. What's your lifetime record?
Karate kicks. Oh, really?
Well, technically,
big 0-1.
I take it back. You're 1-1 because you got him. The making
well,
contact.
You know, I kind of slipped on him a little bit. Kind of glad I didn't hit him.
Yeah.
John Costino, 5'10", 165 pounds, 6'5", 230, barreling at him. Mm-hmm. I could have just tackled him and hit him.
Yeah.
Said, I was going to kick him right in the face.
If you make contact.
I missed.
Oh,
I missed
his
him.
Head would have exploded.
Yeah, he just had a back operation, tried to hurt his back, got sued.
Yeah.
I admire your intentions.
It was. I mean,
right up your alley, right?
Yeah. Yeah. That, I have all due respect for you.
It was a ferocious fight, though. But you see the fight in 82, Minnesota, May 14th. Kind of know it well. But all of a sudden, you see this fight going on. It's a massive fight. All of a sudden, it clears away. Here's this guy. Oh, I think I just showed my leg going snap back position,
yeah.
Carrying me off. It wasn't like today where they could put the mobilizer, mm-hmm. a cart comes out, five doctors.
Yeah.
No, I get up myself. Snap on a car. I remember the cops had the shotguns in the front of the police car.
Right.
I had to get in the front seat.
Yeah.
With a bad left leg. Snap.
Oh, hey, dude, you did more damage on the way to the hospital. Seat.
Yeah.
Dragged me out by the legs.
You were more in the rub some dirt on it era.
Yeah. You know. Hang with him, Rosie.
Yeah.
Next pitcher, call him up. Thanks.
Yeah. Absolutely.
But anyway,
Ray, when you were playing football, do you remember, was there ever a time where you delivered what you would refer to, even moments later, as a complete cheap shot? Like on the like going for a fumble? Like, here's an example that I always think of. When I was in high school, a kid that I went to school with, the coach stopped the tape and said, "Damn it, Jimmy, I told you to keep your fingers out of guys' ear holes," because 20 guys had run on a sweep right, and he had a tight end off the weak side of the offensive line pinned down, and he would tape popsicle sticks to his index finger and jam it in there like a drill.
Yeah. Like,
and he'd sharpen was the kid who we all thought had dirt floors at home and his dad lived on a train somewhere.
What holes did you put fingers into?
Any one I could get to, be honest with you.
That's a good one right there. Right? Right? Yeah. I like the way he was thinking.
That popsicle stick thing is news to me. I wish I'd have thought of that back in the day. To answer your question, not really.
No.
There was one time I didn't like a guy I always thought anytime the offense scored on our defense, the extra point, that was tee off time. Because those poor guys are sitting there and they're squatting down, and then all they do is peek their head out like a, you know.
Right. Because they're not trying to move. They're not trying to move you off the line.
No, they're not firing out.
They're a roadblock.
Oh, so I would get a couple 3-yard head start, time the snap, and just try to take somebody's head off. And one guy had, he spit in my face in a game a few years previously.
Okay. You don't forget that.
Well, no. In fact, I went after him after the game, and that was a big brouhaha. But nonetheless, there he was.
Yeah.
And so I said, oh, here we go. Paybacks again.
And he knows you're coming.
Oh, he knows.
Can see
but
you
there's nothing
him
he
up.
Can do about it. He's a dead duck. Oh, and I smoked him and was on top of him, and I had my fist under his chin strap, just jackhammering. When they finally pulled me off the ground, and
you get a penalty.
Yeah, we had to kick off from the 20, but you know what? It was worth it.
It was
worth it.
Yeah.
Put
your
leg
to it.
Not bad. That's
what you like.
I was willing to pay the fine.
Did you? I was going to say, did you get a fine then?
Not for that one.
What was a fine
I
for
that?
I
did get a fine for something like that. That was in the USFL.
Okay.
I think $50 might have.
Which is crazy. Now
killed
now
me
it's
back
like $25,000.
Yeah. But it would have been worth it.
Yeah,
we played the Jets.
Leave the money on his chest.
Yeah, we played the Jets in my rookie year with Buffalo, and they had the New York sack exchange back then. And Joe Klecko grabbed Jim Kelly and ragdolled him.
Yeah,
and
Klecko was super strong, right?
He was
like
incredible.
One of the strongest men ever.
Yeah, I think he was pre-steroid testing.
Yeah,
but nonetheless,
that's been the rumor.
Jim, I respect his courage, his intelligence, not so much because he went after Klecko.
He did.
And
bad move.
Then the bench is cleared.
Yeah,
and I was down on the end, and I wasn't watching, paying much attention. So I was one of the last guys to get the message. Mm-hmm. But I did run out onto the field. Well, I didn't get to hit anybody, but they had me on film going out on the field being part of this melee.
And since you weren't part of the big group, they could pick out the number easy.
Oh, yeah, they found me. And I got fined $2,500, and my check at the time was $6,000 a week, and then you take taxes out. So you're down to
about
three and change, and then take $2,500 off of that?
Yeah,
Mama was not happy.
No way.
Mama said, don't do that again. So I didn't.
In studio with us, Dave Rozema and Ray Bentley. You got two chances to see these guys later on today. We'll tell you about those in a moment. Dave, back to you for a moment. It just popped into my head the other day, back when I think it was when the Tigers were in the World Series in I think it was 06 when Kenny Rogers had the had his hand.
Yeah.
And I think it was Todd Jones who said, he was just eating some chocolate cake.
Yeah,
in the dugout. What did now that you're well past the time that you played? What did you ever do that would have been completely illegal? While we're talking about all these things that are just outside the rules to doctor the baseball.
Got a great story right here, and it hit me backwards. You know, you try different things.
Mm-hmm.
You try the pine tar, you try a KY, you try to cut the ball. So, you know, your glove. Everybody had a glove here except the trumpet player here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Saxophone.
He was a catcher, though.
Who knows, got pretty lips. So I said, you know what? I'm going to investigate something. So I took a screwdriver and popped the eyelets on my glove.
Mm-hmm.
You make them up. So you point them up to the three right here. So I was trying in the bullpen. Boom, cut the ball. took me a dip. You go, oh, that's pretty good. Like a
yeah.
two
that
and
extra
two,
move, it's a big deal.
Extra movement, 2-1, 2-2, boom, good hitter, down the middle, does something. So I'm going, I'm going to try in the game. Mm-hmm. So I'm all ready to go, because you have to like set it up. Mm-hmm. You're going, okay, when do I do it? All right, I'm going to do it right now. Boom, missed. Hit my four fingers right here. Went,
oh, oh Jesus.
Now they're bleeding. I got a white uniform on.
How does blood do
it's
on
at
the
home.
Ball?
I'm yeah. like, oh. Yeah. So I heard one, tied my shoe, put it in the rosin, scraped it in the dirt. You ever have rosin? It
oh,
stings
it
a little bit.
Yeah.
And they're okay. going, the blood's coming through it. Now I go again, umpire. Oh. Hey, you all right? Hold on.
Hang nail.
Yeah, boom, boom, boom. Put my glove, my hand in my glove so I can hide it. Threw it, boom, somewhere, went somewhere, they caught it, ran in. What happened? I'm going, man, P.O. was our trainer, Bill Beams. I go, look what I did. He goes, what the heck did you do? Washed it off. They were sliced. Matter of fact, probably have scars right now.
Oh, my God.
But I mean,
God.
One of the dumbest things.
Yeah.
But, you know, you try different things. Sparky,
but that goes on every
Sparky,
game, right?
You know what? Somebody cheats every game. Mm-hmm. And I say, if you're not cheating, you're not trying. So, I mean, Emery boards. I like the old tack thing. I tried that one time.
Yeah.
You put it in your glove.
Like
you
have a thumbtack?
You have a Band-Aid.
Yeah.
You take the gauze out. You put a thumbtack on the outside of it.
Okay.
So you take your glove out. You get the ball and you go. Mm-hmm. You wind it up and you're cutting the side of it.
Yeah. And then that helps it grab air. It's going to move a little more.
It moves a little bit, but sometimes the pin gets stuck in your glove. It won't go in.
Oh, great.
Going, hey, come on, this guy. You're going, damn it, this thing won't go in here. No. Then you finally get it in and go. Something's on his glove. Somebody got to check that.
Yeah. So. We had a hitter one time. I forget who it was, but it was some. It might have been Tony Gwynn before he passed. We were talking to him, and we were asking him about pitchers doing things, and it kind of that same thing about maybe the reference might have even been Kenny Rogers with that alleged chocolate cake or whatever, pine tar. And he said, you know what? When it's cold as a hitter, I want them to have something, because otherwise it's harder for them to control the ball, and it's more likely it's going to end up in my ear.
Well, you know, Kenny Rogers, I did a thing with Frank Beckman. Mm-hmm. He called me right after the game. Or, you know, the next day, Rousey, tell me what happened. I go, guilty as charged. And all of a sudden, he goes, well, why would he keep it on his thumb? I go, I thought that was pretty being kind of an idiot. But he says the reason why Tony La Russa didn't call him out on it, because all his pitchers were had pine tar.
Right.
But they kind of hit it.
Yeah. You know, that was what made it amazing
right
was every time he'd put his hand to his mouth to blow his hand, you could see it all. I mean, it was like
it was
better wearing a glove.
And then he had it. Then they showed the Yankees, because remember, he pitched like 21 innings, scoreless ball.
Yeah.
Great slider, great fastball, tail and changeup. And every game, I'm going, God, he's got it on again. And all he did is went, wipe, and he's right there.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like,
it's pretty simple.
Can he hide it?
So that'll be going on today. Maybe not.
Oh, it's going to go on for the next 3 weeks.
Yeah.
I mean, I had pine tar on my hair almost my whole career, every game. Because you're tan.
And everybody knows.
Dark hair. Well, no, I have my sleeve like this.
But like, they know. They don't know, but they know.
They just always said, wow, his curveball always breaks.
Yeah.
You know what? And then sometimes the ball doesn't want to come out. Yeah.
Sticks to your hand.
Yeah. Ray, is there a football equivalent, like a cheat that all the players know, everybody does?
We used to have a couple. We would, you'd take your jersey, and they had this silicone spray.
Yes.
And you'd spray it all over your jersey.
So
guys couldn't grab you.
Yeah.
And then they outlawed that, so we went to Vaseline, and we'd say, oh, it keeps us warm. So we'd cover our arm with Vaseline.
Okay.
Now, back in the locker room. So there were... And then the stick'em was a thing for a while, and then they outlawed that.
Wasn't there a defensive back that was like...
He couldn't take his socks off for 2 weeks. He had so much stick'em on him. They
like
thought
a
that
fly
was
strip.
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Kevin Feifeld is here. He's with BCF Financial Services. Kevin, jump up there and tell everyone exactly, because you know the exact details. I could get my way
this
through
it. This scares
me. And be close enough. Ray, you're not confident in this?
Yeah. I just, the over-under for mistakes is 2.
Okay, let's see.
Okay. All right. Not to put any pressure on you.
I'll let you and Rosie get them.
Yeah. All right. Yeah.
I'm not pouring coffee now.
No, I made sure I put the lid on mine. I know that.
I got a lid on it. No, today at 1 to 3, we're doing an event, autograph, and Dave and Ray's going to have his books there. Dave's going to be autographing. And we also have our friend Jeff Gebbins from All for One Sports coming out to market some sports memorabilia stuff, and with some of the proceeds that are to go back to the Boys and Girls Club from 1 to 3 at the Sports Center Cafe located at Wilson and 56th Street in Granville.
Know exactly where that is.
And that's to benefit the Boys and Girls Club.
Perfect.
So it's going to be a great day there from 1 to 3. Then after that, we jump in our cars, we go up to Howard City to Latitudes. It's a right there, right on Northland, north of Howard City on Northland Drive, to benefit the Max Zamrippa Foundation for Field of Dreams to help kids that are underprivileged be able to achieve the dreams of playing baseball.
That was pretty rad. I didn't hear any
mistakes.
I'm going
to give him a...
That seems 100%
to me. 100%. That was wonderful.
So those are the types of things that are going on today. We're also going to do 50-50 raffles, and I got prizes to give away from BCF Wall Strategies and various baseball information and different things of that nature.
That's how you do it.
Yeah.
That's how you do it right there. That's how you debate.
When he started talking again, I thought, oh,
he's going to ruin it.
Yeah.
He's going to ruin it.
Something.
Perfect. I would never start it up again after the applause. No way I'm going back out.
But it happened.
It was perfect, just like our financial planning.
There you go. Oh, man. Well done. And the third
time's
a charm.
He's on today, people.
Yes.
Now,
Kevin did forget to say that all autographs are free. And it's all it is just personal donations, whatever you want to give.
Oh, that's fantastic.
That's right.
That is fantastic.
That's nice.
Yeah. I can't get anyone to pay for mine, so
that's why they're free.
Let's try it this way. Maybe that'll work.
Before we went on the air, Joe had seen something in the press release that Ray had shared with us.
Yeah.
And you started to ask Rosie about it. I said, hold on, we got to discuss this on the air.
Yeah. This is the press release that you guys sent us. This isn't from Wikipedia. It said... Rosie was recently featured on the show American Pickers. And so I said, are you a full-time picker? And you went, what?
Yeah.
And I said, you're an American picker. You're on that show. It says right here.
I have to, I'm not getting any revenues from it.
But were you on it?
I was never on it. This is somebody just filming me on the side and saying, yeah, there he is. He's in it.
Are you a picker?
I go to estate sales. Is that considered a picker?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, I have no idea what a picker is.
Oh, I love doing that.
Kind of, but that's not quite the same.
Bro, this is a barn
because it's
show
a regular,
going in and
yeah, like that's
up
like
in front of a car and go, oh, I'll buy this for, give you $20 for it.
Yeah.
Boom. No, I've never been filmed.
Why is that
on
the internet then?
And I would, you know what? We're Sam Bernstein.
Oh, that's we called. What the hell? Call Sam.
Oh, nope. Mm-hmm. We shouldn't say that.
Yeah.
I am so perplexed.
Saul, we'll call Saul.
Now, I searched for this. I searched Dave Rozema, American Pickers. Did you do that?
No.
I did, yeah. Oh, it comes up with an episode called Bike Pickin' Paradise.
You pick some bikes?
No.
Yeah, they said you're an expert on motorcycles.
I mean, I drive around in my car.
None of them had seats.
For the trash in Grosse Pointe. Is that considered a picker?
No,
I don't do that. No, I've never been on a show. Never.
No.
I wish I have. It can be kind of fun.
We're going to find you.
That definitely doesn't look like you.
Yeah, maybe it's just a guy named Dave Rozema.
I mean, that's possible,
I
suppose.
Put this together.
You know, I've done a few autograph sessions over in the Holland area, Jenison, Allendale, and I've had gentlemen come up, boxes, and I go, yeah, can I help you? Can I sign right here? He goes, no, here's your stupid mail. Box full of it. I go, he goes, I'm Dave Rozema. I go, oh, nice to meet you, Dave Rozema. He goes, I'm Dave Rozema. I go, R-O-Z? He goes, R-O-Z. Next autograph session, he's going to have another kid. You go, here you go, Mr. Rozema, here's a package. I go, what's in it? He goes, your mail. I'm Dave Rozema. I'm Dave Rozema. I think there's probably 10 Dave Rozemas in the Grand Rapids area.
Really?
Now one in Detroit.
That doesn't surprise me.
So, and there's obviously one on the picker show.
Yeah, I guess so.
That has
with
to be what it is.
Got your mail.
Yeah, blocking my mail coming up.
There you go.
All right.
You know, it was also brought to my attention, this article. I kept getting hit in the shoulder going, click on that link.
And
it's the one that says Dave Rozema ranks as one of the Detroit Tigers' all-time biggest flakes.
Yeah, didn't want you to do that.
I saw that one too, and I went, he's pretty laid back, should I ask?
But by the way, you know, somebody from the Tiger organization, Alan Trammell, who's widely respected, told me in January, this Dave Rozema is the best of the former Tigers to come out and do autograph sessions.
I believe
so. I got to commend David.
There you go. Thank you. So
everybody
come on
loves
out and see
the
me
plate.
Today.
That's
and
right.
Ray.
Well, you're on the list with Mark Fidrich, whom everybody loves that guy
love
as well.
Him.
Yeah.
Yep.
Loved
matter
that
of fact,
guy.
Doing a Major League Baseball is doing a biography on him.
Oh, that'll be fantastic.
And I'm going to actually do a couple spots. Hold back and keep the tears down, but he actually was my roommate for 3.5 years.
No kidding.
During the summer, we couldn't do it. Too much fun.
Yeah.
Then I used to come back to Grand Rapids.
Yeah.
And we'd say it was a 2-bedroom apartment. And go, oh, this is kind of fun.
Yeah.
Nothing like staying with a bird.
Oh, man.
He was in studio one time with us. He came and did a signing with the Whitecaps.
He's a great dude.
That
and
was,
he was,
yeah,
bless his
was
soul.
He? When I was 5 years old, my brother went to his first Tigers game. He was older than me, and he brought me home a picture of the bird. And that was when I thought that was the most amazing thing. And then growing up, that was my point of reference. You know, I would have been four. His 77 was his.
76 was his main year.
I was three and then four. So, right. But that was like the beginning was, oh, yeah, the bird. So when I was first playing wiffle ball, I was the bird before I even knew what it meant.
Talking to the wiffle ball?
Oh, yeah, still I still would.
So 77, that was my year. So what do you think?
I picked up basketball. Okay. Dave Rozema, Ray Bentley, you can go see him today. Couple different locations. Later in the day at Howard City's Latitudes and Steelheads. That's from 6 until 10. And then this afternoon, Sports Center Cafe at 56th and Wilson in Granville.
Very good.
Guys, great to see you.
You almost did that as well as Mr. Fifield. I got to
know. He did, he did it without notes, though.
Yeah. So.
I didn't need to lip sync.
There you go.
Yeah, he works with no net.
That's right.
He's like a Walenda.
Flying.
That's it for us. We'll see you later. It's 97.9 GRD Rocks.